Good morning and welcome to this week's Weekly Hack. My name is Steve Durham and today is May 13th, 2020, and we will be talking about safely removing and replacing your augers and liners in your 90 extruder. This may not be the quick way, but we think this is the safe way. So parts can be sent to their parts at jcsteele.com. Don't forget you can save 2% on all your wear parts on online ordering. You can also see the previously recorded Weekly Hacks on our LinkedIn page or on the YouTube playlist provided here. And of course, as always, lock out and tag out your machine before you start these jobs. So tools to have on hand would be the auger removal tool, two of the auger adapter tools, auger installation tool, and you can see those on the photo here. We also suggest you have 2 3/4 by 60 inch long puller rods, anti-seize or grease, and silicone. All those will help with the removal and the installation of your auger liners. So with the chain position like this, this person's going to have a tough time maneuvering this adapter and liners to get it back on the keyway. So using the barrel adapter tools extends the keys out past the barrel would help. Also using the eye bolt to safely lift it up helps keep your fingers out of the way of this. If you have a hinged door, first you remove the shear bolt and swing the doors back out of the way. Next, you'll need to remove the front barrel adapters and clamp ring that holds the L10 liner. Make sure to have a replacement gasket or seal on hand when you replace the adapter, because you need to seal this off. For those with hydride die changers, separate the carriers in the, as you see in the photo here, and the clamp ring will be exposed. Make sure that you mark that liner key where it's going right there. I've seen people try to put that all over the place. And this is a good place to, when you mark it, it also lines up your bolts as well. On the left, we see the clamp ring exposed. This should be removed first. Notice the liner key position before removing the liner. Using the adapter and the installation tool we show you in the right will help you clear the front of the barrel and keep your worker safe. You can get it out and away from the front end of that. With the ring and liner removed, you're now ready to remove the first adapter ring that holds the 8 and 9 liner. Using the 2 puller rods that we talked about, screw them into the adapters, which has provided holes, 0 3/4 tapped holes. You can actually pull those liners out, or the adapters out. And now all the adapters have these tapped holes in them. You are now ready to remove the left-handed point auger stud and the cut washer. Then remove your point auger. Using the auger installation tool, you can clear the front and then safely lift it up and out of your way. Next, you'll need to remove the middle adapter. Using the puller rod and the adapter tool, you can again clear the front of the machine for safe removal. Now the number 7 auger is ready to be removed, and using the auger puller, you can start it and then use your hooks to pull it out and clear the barrel area. Then you're ready to pull this rear adapter out. With all the adapters removed, you can remove the number 6 auger and the number 1 rear liner, and then you can get the number 5. And if you're changing a full set of augers, it's time to pull your fast feeds after that. Clean the barrel and the vacuum chamber of any material that's in there. Inspect your keyways on your shaft and on the barrel there, and also check your cat seal. So good time to do that. When checking your adapter keys, make sure that you check all of them. There's 4. There's 2 longer ones in the barrel and then 2 short ones back in the vacuum chamber part of it. And this is also a good time to check your pan liner. Good thing to do is the day before is light all your augers and liners that you're going to be replacing. Put them in order that they'll need to be put in, and that way you're ensure that you have all the items that you need. You'll need to move the liners out of the adapters and clean the adapters on the outside and the inside before replacing your new liners. Here we see a bead of silicone that's been put on the back side of the hub. You want to smooth it down to about a 1/16 inch. This allow it to cure. This will keep material out of the pockets for the puller and actually make the puller pulling the augers easier, because you won't have the material built up on the inside of it. So here you can see that silicone acting as a gasket to keep the material from a shaft and the puller pockets. Proper installation of your augers ensures that minimum force is required to remove your augers. This includes using anti-seize and or grease on your shaft. So a good coating of anisees or grease on the shaft or inside the auger, and then especially on the keyways of the adapters, not only will help the installation, but also removal the next time you have to change your augers and liners. You can see the difference, different ways of putting it in, as this person put it in the hub. How to tell your auger or your liners front from the back, you'll need to, if you have wedge liners, the number will be in the dimple, as you see on the keyway here on the left. If you have spirals, the dimple will be blank, but the number will be on the inside, and it's always on the front, so those numbers should be facing towards the point auger. So unlike your liners, the augers have a casting identification on the back wing. So when you install those, make sure that's going back towards the gearbox. Be sure that the wings are not touching, and also that the point auger stud is left hand, and it does not have to be torqued, it's just hand tight, because all your force is being pushed backwards. So you're simply installing in reverse order as you disassembled, and you shouldn't have any issues. If you do, please just give us a call, and we'll be here, happy to help you. Order and charts have these laid out as well. So whether you have HCV or HTR augers, both are listed in your order chart and can be checked out there. Here's our contact information. If you do have questions, or if you have any other questions, please just feel free to give us a call, send us a text or email. You see my information there. You got your sales reps information on there as well. So please just give us a call. We're available for you anytime. And of course, we're part of a larger group. So any of your heavy clay needs, we're here to help you out. And just use us and contact us. Give us any kind of anything you have. We'd love to help you out. I'd like to thank you for joining us today, and we'd like to open it up for any questions. Thank you.